Bryan Danielson began his professional wrestling career in 1999 on the independent circuit. Between 1999 to 2009, he wrestled around the world, in companies such as Ring of Honor, New Japan Pro Wrestling and World Wrestling Federation. From 2009 to 2021, he wrestled under the name of Daniel Bryan in WWE. In 2021, he recently joined All Elite Wrestling. Bryan Danielson is described as a submission specialist. He mostly used submissions moves through his career. He is known to have a large diversity of finishing maneuvers compared to most wrestlers, who use a unique finisher. Since some of his finishers were rarely used, I divided the finisher list into honorable mentions, secondary finishers, and main finishers. In the honorable mentions, we have the double wristlock with repeated kicks to the head. Rarely used as a finisher, most of the time as a signature move. The crucifix elbow strike, rarely used as a finisher, most of the time as a signature move. He notably beat Nigel McGuinness with 33 strikes to win the unified ROH world title. At one time in ROH, as a heel, he even used a small package pin as his finisher. Bryan was then nicknamed Mr. Small Package. During his short run in WWF, he was trained by William Regal. As a tribute to him, he used the Regal-Plex as his finisher couple of times. And finally, the airplane spin. Used to beat Homicide in ROH, after 100 spins. In the secondary finishers, we can quote three submission moves. The Crossface Chickenwing, the Triangle Choke and the Cobra Clutch. All these moves were used between 2001 to 2010. Let's watch these finishers now. Finishers, we can now classify them based on the date. His first finisher was the Bridging Dragon Suplex, used between 1999 to 2001. It became thereafter a signature move on the indie scene, but it was never used in WWE, due to the restricted moves aiming the head, one of the rules in WWE. His second finisher was the Cattle Mutilation, also called the Arms Across America, which is a bridging double chicken wing. Used between 2001 to 2010 and now in AEW. He used it few times as a regular move in WWE. Then when he joined WWE, he used the LeBell lock, also called the Yes lock, which is a Omoplata crossface. A move that he still uses now in AEW. In 2011, he used few time, the Guillotine choke as a finisher. In 2013, he surprisingly beat John Cena at SummerSlam, with a new finisher, the running high knee, called sometimes the Knee Plus, as a reference to when Triple H and the Authority called him AB Plus. And finally, the heel hook since 2018. Danielson said that he wanted this move to be his finisher when he debuted in WWE in late 2009. Enjoy this finishers in the recap now. That's the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed it. Every comments and likes are really appreciated. Click in the description down below for more informations and feel free to debate the finisher list and the date.